everybody, and welcome to my first Let's Play. Let's get this show on the road. Well, I mean, I guess so you could call it a Let's Play, whatever. I'm not really planning on doing this for the first time. As my first Let's Play, you know, just kind of fucking around with this one. Matter of fact, let's not call it this. It is Let's Fuck Around with Final Fantasy IX. My personal favorite Final Fantasy of all time. Nah, just kidding, it's 13. No! Nobody liked Final Fantasy 13. Just admit it's a horrendous hack job and everyone knows it. Published by Square Electronic Arts LLC. It is Squaresoft. Well. New game because... Gee! Are we gonna start from a continue new game where I beat Nazma and everything? Hell no. Well, that would be more appropriate for a fuck around, but... not as fun. Hideo Manaba. Oh my god. 13-2 is gonna be horrible. I just wanna say that out loud. Like, 13-2 is going to be terrible and everyone knows it. Everyone knows it. Even I know it, but guess what? I'm still gonna wanna play the game for some reason. Nobuo Uematsu. God, if I've offended anyone Japanese, listen. Nobody Japanese is gonna listen to this. Who am I kidding? Only a total of like 3 people are gonna hear this, including myself, by the way. Fujii. Real time graphics. Real time. What exactly is real time? Yusushi Kurosawa. May sound like I'm making fun of this, but I really do love this game. I've tried 7. I think it's just like with a thing that usually it's your first Final Fantasy game that you fall in love with. And this was definitely my first. I got it like a year after it came out, so I got like his greatest hits release. And then I found Final Fantasy VII for $5 at a pawn shop. Oh, the greatness. God, it's just weird when you play Final Fantasy IX first and then you go backwards. And it's like, man, this is just not as good as Final Fantasy IX. But if you go 7 to 9 and you're like, oh, what the hell did they do to the sequel? Final Fantasy VII was amazing. I just always liked the characters in Final Fantasy IX better. I always liked that it was more lighthearted. You know, like the story better. I thought Final Fantasy VII was like way too melodramatic. Aboard the, shit, I actually forgot the name of the ship. Did they ever name the ship? It's like the fucking... Here's our man of the story. You know, I don't think they ever, like, explain the monkey tails in the game. It's just like, whatever, they got them. They're born with them, you know. They. Spoilers. Should I spoil this game? It doesn't really matter. This game is over 10 years old anyway. Sure is dark. Guess nobody's here yet. Oh my god. This is so weird. I'm recording this on instant DVD recorder, if anyone wants to know. Wow. This is so weird. Because before I was worried because before I started recording, it was like delayed by like a full second. I was like, shit, how am I going to do this? But, you know, I guess it's normal now. Well, it's still like half a second delay, but still, it's better. Better than a full second delay, I think. Classic. No, I always like normal. Gray was the way to go. Is there anything over here? No, it's like over here. No. Shit, I don't remember anything. Okay, 47 gil. And a potion. No reason to get anything else in the room. I think there's like something about like you can answer Alexandria quizzes or something like that later on. Zidane. I'm calling him Zidane. I know like I think his official pronunciation is Zidane from fucking... Shit, what is it? What's the fighting game called? Oh my god, I can't remember what the Final Fantasy fighting game is called anymore. Dissidious, that's it. Holy shit. But yeah, I don't like how anybody's voice been Dissidious. I don't care, Michael. Nobody knows who Michael is. Shut up. Now here's the question. Does Baku normally do this? Like, really? Oh, well, first real boss battle. And It's... do they give him a name before you actually find out who he is? I don't know. Masked Man. Oh, shit. What? Oh, my God. That's what I get for being nervous on my first try out. I don't think I can heal him either. Oh, my God. Oh, well, I got all the things I need. Do I have a phoenix down? I have a phoenix down. Use that shit, Marcus. I don't even think you get experience points from this, but I am not gonna let Zidane die on the very first boss battle. Just have everybody attack you at this point. It really doesn't matter. He only has two items anyway. Senna's usually the one to die. What the hell? I mean, that was a fuck up on my part, of course. Attack! And you just attack him and attack him and attack him until he is dead. It's a great boss fight, you know. It's a great introduction into the game. Actually, if you notice that about a lot of games, is almost all games... Games love to start off with the whole boss fight you can't win or lose thing. Like, I remember Lord of the Rings, the Third Age. Oh my God, you played Lord of the Rings, the Third Age? Yes, and I liked it. It was kind of difficult. What? Oh yeah, I forgot, like, when I, shit, I don't know why he says that. I guess, like, if you have really low hit points, it says that, but oh my God, I've only encountered him saying that, like, twice. And I have played this game, like, 8,000 times. Hey, fools! You're looking a lot better! Guaha! Whose laugh starts with a G, like, a G sound? Next time I'm gonna laugh, I'm gonna intentionally just start off with Guah! And the greatest hidden trick is coming up. Everyone who knows about this game knows what I'm talking about. Tantalus, the infamous man. Daring Thieves. That's us. What does he do? Say that in whispers. Doc's an I forgot what the name of the ship is called. I'm pretty sure he already said it. Oh my God. Break a leg, Marcus. You're gonna eat lightning. Oh my God, our first reference, I think. Oglops. They don't really explain what an Oglop is either. I think this is the only Final Fantasy game that has it. That's when I kidnapped Queen Braun, right? Fat ass butt ugly. Oh my God, we're starting off a Final Fantasy game with cussing! So yeah, if you do that 64 times, Ruby will, you know, bust into the room, stupid scene, blah 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 blah. I never do it because it's pointless. Babelicious beauty and all of Alexandria. And here we enter our next CGI scene. This is terrible because I'm playing this on the PS3. And, usually right after this CGI scene ends, the game freezes up on me. So, here's the hoping it doesn't. Gotta hope it doesn't. Shinji Hashimoto is coming to attack you. That sounded racist, that accent I just did, but believe me, I was not trying. I'm a racist and I don't even know it. The things you learn when you play Final Fantasy games. What life lessons has Final Fantasy taught you today? I have learned that I should build a sword on top of my fucking castle. Oh man, yeah. Wait, is that a sword? I know it's Alexander, but yeah, it is. It's a sword coming out of the castle. That's so stupid. And even the Final Fantasy 9 logo, it's a sword coming out of a crystal. It's kind of fucking weird looking. Conceived. Oh my God. Why can I not say the word conception or conceive without some kind of weird thought running through my mind? Somebody gave birth to the idea of Final Fantasy 9. Ugh. Yes. Oh God, it froze up, didn't it? I've had this disc for 10 years, and I admit, even though I do take really good care of my games, yeah, it is froze up. Oh yeah, there's the green block of death. Well, that was nice all knowing you. Well, I mean, like, it plays pretty good on the PS2, so maybe if I do really try to let's play this game, I'll try it on the PS2. Not really a guarantee that this will be my first real let's play, though. This is just a fuck around, like I said. But bye-bye, everybody!